Hi, welcome to Mentum Ellipse 8. Quick tips. In today's quick tip, we're going to learn how to add custom geodata to your project. So here are the most common questions on this topic. What type of geodata can I add to the project? Which formats are supported by Ellipse? How do I add the files to the project? And finally, can I use multiple files in a single project? So, what type of geodata can I add? You can add terrain files. These would be raster format files with ground height above sea level for every pixel. You can add clutter files. These would represent the land use for every pixel. For example, residential, forest, water, etc. You can add clutter height files. These will also be in raster format and they will represent obstacle height above ground. And finally, you can add polygon files. These are very detailed files with obstacle shapes and height above ground. Which formats are supported by Ellipse? We support various formats like MapInfo raster and polygon files, Esri polygon files, MapInfo interchange format files, and also binary files. How can I add the files to my project? Inside Ellipse, you're going to have to go into the Project Settings menu, then look for the GIS node, and then Data Sources. Here, you're going to select the files that you want to add to your project. And then you're going to go into the Profile Sources node, where you're going to enable those files so that they are visible under the microwave link profiles. Can I use multiple files in a single project? Yes, of course you can. And these files can also have different resolutions if you want. Now let's go into the tool. Here is the project we had created previously for Hawaii with three low resolution geodata. To add the new files, you're going to click on the home menu, then you're going to click on project settings. Then you're going to go into GIS and then data sources. You're going to notice there are two different folders in here, one called vector and one called raster. We're going to start with the raster folder. Click on Add Layer, then you can select either a folder or a file. Click on the Browse button, then select the file that you want to add. You can select either the GRD or the TAP file. You can then rename the file however you want and enable the checkbox at the bottom. This will tell Ellipse that the values in the file will be used as AMSL values in meters. Click OK. Then you can repeat the same procedure for the other files. You're now done with the terrain. You can start adding the clutter files in the same way. Something you can do with clutter files as well is that you can add a height table. And here you will specify the individual height per clutter class. That way you can add this to your microwave link line of sight profile. The last step is to add a building polygons file. You can do that under the vector node. Just click on Add Layer, browse for your file, select it, and make sure you enable the height checkbox at the bottom. This is telling Ellipse that you're going to use the values in the file as AGL values. That stands for above ground level. The column in the file to be selected for the values is also called AGL. Click OK. Now you can remove all the files that you're not going to use anymore. In this case, we're going to remove the free geodata that we had added before. As a final step, you're going to go into the Profile Sources node and you're going to enable every single file that you just added. Terrain, buildings, and clutter. Then click OK. That's it. You're done. See you in the next quick tip.